Hi guys, welcome to another MailChimp tutorial video. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to embed the form using a WordPress plugin. The plugin we're going to look at is called MailChimp for WordPress. So I'll copy the name, then I'll go to my WordPress dashboard, add new, I'll paste the name here to search for it. Here it is. You can see it was last updated 1 week ago. That means it's an active plugin, so it's safe to use. So we'll click install now. Then we'll activate the plugin. So we need to go to the plugin settings. You can see it is here. Just click on that. Well, you can see mine. I've already added my API. So if you don't have an API already, you can go here, get your API key. For me, I had created this one, and this is the one I want to use. So I'll just copy it. If you don't have an API key already, you'll see this button of create a key. Just click on it and the key will be created. So you see I've created another key. Yeah, so you can use any. If you don't have an API key already, you'll see this button. Just click on that, then copy the key that is created, come back and paste it here. So I'll disable this key once I'm done with the tutorial, so don't try to use it. Then save changes. So as you can see, it brings all of the lists that I have. If I had more than one list, it would bring them here. And it also brings all the fields that the list has. Our list has an email, a first name and a second name. That's all we need to do here. Then you'll go to forms. The first thing you need to do, so you'll select the list. If there are other lists here, you'll need to select one from the list that you want the contact form to be subscribed to. What that means is, once the form is created and people subscribe, which lists do you want them to be added to? That's exactly what this is all about. So once we select this, you can see all the fields in the list are here. You want to add the fields, any fields that you need, you'll add them here. So if all you needed was the email, then this would be enough. But you also want to add the first name. You can change the name if you want to. Initial value, you can input an initial value. Wrap in paragraph, p tags, that's what this is about. Required field, yes. Add to form, yes, you can just add to form. Once you click on add to form, you can see the first name was added here. Then I'll come back and choose second name. Well, this is not a required field, but you can click here to make it required. Then, doing the same thing, just come here, click, then click on add to form, and it will be added where the cursor was. Then you'll save the changes. Once we've saved those settings, now the form is ready. What I want to do is take a look at the settings down here. So you can see MailChimp double opt-in. Double opt-in, if you select yes, people will need to confirm their sign up. If you choose no, they'll be directly subscribed to the list. There are a whole bunch of other settings here. Hide form after successful sign up. You can choose to hide the form once someone subscribes successfully. Redirect to URL after successful signup. If you have a page maybe for downloading something, you can put the link here once they have subscribed. Or it can be a thank you page. You can put the link here, and once they click on the button, it will automatically redirect them to this page. Successfully subscribed. So these are the messages. These are feedback messages. As you can see, if someone inputs an invalid email address, if a field is required, if someone is already subscribed, if there's a general error, these are the list you, these are just feedback information. If your form was being translated, if you had translated your form to another language, you'll have to come here and translate the language, translate all of this into your particular language. So the next thing we have to do, embed this form on our page. So to embed the form on the page, you will come here and select this. So as you can see, you can display the form inside a post, inside a page, or a text widget. So before I take a look at this, let's just go to the page, pages, embed it on one page. And then we can see how changing the CSS options here will make things different. So I'd created this page. So just like that, once I save, I update the page, then I view the page. As you can see, the styling is pretty terrible. If we go back to the plugin, MailChimp for WordPress, then we go into forms. So if we take this, yes, low default theme, let's take the black, the dark theme, this one, the dark theme, then we come and save the changes. We see how that will appear. Well, you can see that that does something, but not much. I'm guessing that the issue is with my theme. Let's try the light theme. The issue is the theme I'm using, but all of that is not a problem because you can style all of this with CSS. If you have a bit of knowledge in CSS, you can style this yourself. Yeah, so you can see this is the form that comes up, but you can style this yourself. Using the Firebug plugin, you can select the items and style them one at a time. But maybe in your theme it will appear different because I've used this plugin in other themes and it appeared better than it does now. So if you take a look at the other form, whereby all we did was embed the code directly to the page, it looks pretty neat. Even for this, it looks pretty neat. This is why I still prefer embedding the code directly like I did with this. But if you feel you need to use a plugin, why not? Go ahead and use the plugin. Plus the plugin, I can see, comes with other options. At the end of the day, this is just doing the same thing that you would have done, taking the code from MailChimp, pasting it into a page. It's just the same thing. Okay guys, that does it for this video. Thanks guys, until next time.